This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to learn the most important identity in trigonometry, called the fundamental identity. So first of all, what is an identity? It's an equation that is true for all values of the variable for which both sides of the equation are defined. So here's an example. 2x equals x plus x. No matter what value you put in for x, this will be true. Or 4x over x, the x's will always cancel and make that equal to 4. So it doesn't matter what value you put in for x, right? As long as you don't put in 0 for x, because that would be an example where the left side wasn't defined. Or 3 times x minus 2 is the same as 3x minus 6. Doesn't matter what number you put in for the variable, this will always be true. So before we get to the identity, we want to understand this way of writing sine of a squared. So instead of having to always put the parentheses when we're going to square the sine of a, in other words, sine of a times sine of a, we just write it like this, sine squared a. So it's not like the sine's being squared, it's the sine of a is being squared. This is a short cut notation so that you don't have to put the parentheses. And you're not squaring the sine, it's the sine of a that is being squared, all right? So you cannot write sine of a squared, because that means a is being squared and then you're taking the sine. That's completely different. It is not the same thing. So it means you're taking the sine of a and then squaring it. All right, same thing. If you want to take the cosine of b and then cube it, you could just write cosine cubed b like this. So that's a way of leaving off the parentheses. Remember, you always have to say what the angle is. You can't just write sine squared or cosine cubed. That doesn't make any sense. You have to say the sine of what. All right, now when we first defined the trig functions, remember it was defined that if you have a point, x, y, in the plane, right, and it's a point on the terminal side of an angle theta in standard position, and r is equal to square root of x squared plus y squared. Remember that came from the distance formula or the Pythagorean theorem. Then we came up with these definitions for the sine of theta, the cosine theta, and the tangent of theta. So using these definitions, what would the cosine of theta squared, remember what this means, it means the cosine of theta times the cosine of theta. Well, the cosine of theta is x over r. So this would be x over r squared, or you could put x over r times x over r, plus, what's the sine squared? The sine of theta squared. Well, the sine is y over r squared. So what does that equal? That's x squared over r squared plus y squared over r squared. And now you have a common denominator. So I could just write x squared plus y squared in the numerator, all over r squared. Which is, well, what is x squared plus y squared? All right, now if you go back up to this right here, let's see. Remember where that came from. If this is your point x, y, right? And this was r. It's because we have an x and a y, and the Pythagorean theorem says x squared plus y squared equals r squared, right? That's why r is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So this x squared plus y squared is really the same thing as r squared. So I really just have r squared over r squared, which equals 1. Okay. So here's the bottom line. No matter what theta is, if I'm going to do cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta, so it doesn't matter if that's 10 degrees or 2 pi or any other angle you want, or it could be in radians as well, you're always going to get an answer of 1. That's the fundamental identity. Cosine squared of an angle plus sine squared of the same angle is the same as 1. And it doesn't matter if you write it as cosine squared of the angle plus sine squared theta or sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, right? So here we go. Here is the fundamental identity. Sine squared theta plus the cosine squared of theta equals 1. That's something you never want to forget. It's the most important identity in trig. Let's do a quick example to prove the point. Let's say I have this common 3, 4, 5 triangle, and we'll call this theta right here, right? So what is the sine of theta in this picture? It would be opposite over hypotenuse, or 3 fifths. And the cosine of theta would be the adjacent over hypotenuse, or 4 fifths. And according to the fundamental identity, if I do sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, it should equal 1. So let's just try that out. If I do sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, in this particular problem, that's 3 fifths squared plus 4 fifths squared. So that's 9 25ths plus 16 25ths, which is 25 25ths, which does equal 1. So we can see it checks out. And you could plug any other angle you want in for there for theta. All right, on the next video, we'll see how we could use this identity to find the trig function of some angle if we only know the sine or the cosine. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.